My name is Celine Awol. I work for the International Institute for Legislative Affairs, in short, Iila. We work on policy issues, so we do research to generate information to support policy advocacy on key areas such as public health and especially control and prevention of non-communicable diseases. We also do some work in the area of extractives and governance. So the work that we do supports implementation or achievement of SDG number 3, mm-hmm. that is good health and well-being. Mm-hmm. Specifically, I would say two targets, that is 3.4, which is reducing mortality in the NCDs and especially mental health, promote mental health and well-being, mm-hmm. and target 3A, which is to strengthen and fast-track implementation of the FCTC, that is the Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, in countries. The VINA reporting is relevant because I think CSOs really do a lot of work. They contribute to implementation and the goal for their vision to achieve these SDGs, which most of the times, unfortunately, maybe is not well captured. So this process gives us the opportunity to contribute, to also share the work that we do and how it advances and contributes, complements what other actors are doing, including government, to ensure that Kenya actually achieves the SDGs. I can give probably two examples. First is in line with the FCTC. So the work that we do, as I mentioned, is to support control and prevention of NCDs, focusing on the risk factors. And these the major risk factors for NCDs are four. One of them is tobacco consumption, harmful consumption of alcohol, then their diet-related unhealthy diets, and physical inactivity. So in the area of where we've worked on so much is tobacco consumption, so that is tobacco control, as one of ways of reducing or preventing and controlling NCDs. And what we have achieved so far is that one of the strategies that have been tested and evidence-based that actually can lead to significant reduction in tobacco consumption is tax and price measures. So we have done and continue to do a lot of advocacy for increase on tax in tobacco products. And just as of last year, we got an increase of 15% on excise duty on tobacco products. And this is important because of, I can say three. Number one, when prices of tobacco products and cigarettes is increased, it encourages people to quit. And even more importantly, it prevents initiation of young people into smoking, mm-hmm. and also generates income for government that can actually be plowed back in public health programs. I think in the space of NCD control and prevention, I think there's still more that needs to be done. Number one, NCDs currently are a big threat and a big burden to health, Kenya and globally. In Kenya, as of survey done by the STEP survey of 2015, indicated that Kenya, up to 50% of hospital deaths are as a result of NCDs, mm-hmm. and up to 55% of admissions are actually from NCDs. And that was 2015. I mean, by now it's high. We know how, we hear cases. I mean, each family, you have a case of somebody who is battling cancer or several other NCDs. Yeah. So I think this is an area that is critical, but so much more still needs to be done. And I think the actors in this space need to work together, because as of now, I think we are mostly, like us, Iila, we've been working a lot on tobacco control, so we are trying to get involved in the other risk factors, for instance, diet-related risk factors. Mm. And so there's need for all the actors, both state and non-state actors, to come together, to put some kind of united interventions so that we jointly, you know, address this issue from, how can I put it, from all angles. So whether it is policy interventions, whether it is public education, and all other interventions that we need, all the programs that we need to promote prevention. So we need to invest more in prevention measures, because that will save us a lot when it comes to treatment. Yeah, that also just links back to what you just talked about. Yep, I think we still, a lot more still needs to be done in terms of working together, building synergies from all the actors who are working on NCD control and prevention, and also this in terms of also producing, generating and sharing data that can actually better inform our reporting on the on SDG target 3.4, because I'm sure there are several actors working on various interventions that, you know, contribute to realization of these targets, but maybe it's not available at some kind of, it's not well coordinated or available at the same point. So I think we need to stop working in silos. All the actors, whether we are looking at the risk factors or we are looking working with communities for the people who are affected, or whether we are looking at policy interventions, we need to be in the same room, if I can call it that, so that we work together, generate the evidence together, and make sure that we are reporting exactly what we are doing. Yeah.